हॅलो एव्हरीबडी, आय एम केतन जोगळेकर, वर्किंग ॲज अ असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्प्युटर सायन्स, गोपटे जोगळेकर कॉलेज, रत्नागिरी, महाराष्ट्र, अँड हॅविंग 11+ years ऑफ एक्सपिरियन्स इन टीचिंग.
आय एम द इन्स्ट्रक्टर फॉर धिस ट्युटोरियल. विथ धिस ट्युटोरियल द लर्नर शॅल बी एबल टू व्हॉट इज क्लोनिंग अँड इमेजिंग, हाऊ टू क्रिएट forensic image using FTK imager, how to analyze forensic data using FTK imager, and finally how to recover deleted data or evidence using FTK imager. Disk cloning means cloning a hard drive during collection uses a target drive to make an exact duplicate, that is bitstream copy, of the original hard drive. This process is normally completed using hardware referred to as hard drive cloning equipment. But for cloning same capacity or higher capacity is required and can be used to retain the original and do the analysis on the cloned disk. Disk imaging means imaging a hard drive. It is a phrase that is commonly used for preserving the contents of custodian hard drive or server. It can also be used to describe when custodian hard drive is cloned. It is worth taking some time to understand the differences and advantages and disadvantages of each process. In this process, data is saved as a disk to file as .dd, E01 or raw file. That means we have to work more and more on less originals, and for creating image of a suspect disk, we have to connect that suspect disk or drive to write blocker. So for creating image, we use free tool that is available online and free to download, and that free tool name is FTK imager. So we will start creating image for suspect drive, and for this we have to start FTK imager. After starting FTK imager, just we have to click on yes button. After starting FTK imager, go to file menu, and in this file menu we have to click on create image here. So in this we will see number of options for source. So here we will see some source options like physical drive, logical drive, image file, contents of folder, and FENICO device like CD or DVD. Okay, so we will see these source options first. So we will see what is physical drive, what is logical drive, image file, and so on things. So what is physical drive? Just we have to see some another options, how to identify the physical drive or logical drive, and just go to this PC, right click, and have to go on manage. So here we will select disk management. It will take some time. So here we have to go to disk management in storage tab, left side, left panel tree structure. In left tree structure, there is one option storage, and in the storage section there is disk management. So we'll go to disk management, and in this there are some options like disk 0, disk 1, CD-ROM 0, and so on things. Okay, so here are disk 0, disk 1 are the physical drives. Okay, so we will know about whatever the physical drive is. So disk 0, disk 1, and CD-ROM, these are the physical drives that are the physically available in our machine or our computer or laptop. So disk 0, that means our hard disk, main HDD drive, and disk 1 means here I am connecting the pen drive, okay, that is having 8 GB of capacity with FAT32 file system. And our hard disk for Windows, there is NTFS file system for our hard disk. Okay, so there are some letters like C, G, D, whatever. So these letters, like Windows, for Windows there is a C drive, G drive and D drive. Okay, so these letters C, G and D, these drives are called as the logical drive, because this physical drive disk 0 having some partitions. Okay, so these partitions having letters like C, G and D. So these C, G and D are the logical drives. Okay, so I think you know idea about the what is the physical drive and what is the logical drive. Okay, so we will switch to our topic, that is to creating a image. So we have to so it is the recommendation, when you create an image of a suspect drive, so we have to select the physical drive, okay, not a logical drive. Okay, so say after selecting physical drive, we click on next button. So after clicking the next button, here we will see some physical drives like physical drive 0 and physical drive 1. So as we see in the disk management tab or disk management dialog box, there are disk 0 and disk 1. So here are showing the drive 0 and drive 1. So drive 0 is the our hard disk of 1 TB hard disk, and having one disk 1, that is called as the pen drive of 8 GB capacity. So we have to select that pen drive 8 GB. Okay, so we have to select that 8 GB pen drive location and then click on finish button. So after clicking on finish button, here some data. Okay, so that is the requirement for creating the image. So image source is the drive 1, that means disk 1. Then we have to select the destination, that is where we want to save that image in our hard drive. Okay, so we have to add that destination by clicking add button. Okay, so by clicking that particular add button, here are showing some number of options, that is select image type. Okay, so we will see some image types one by one first. So there are four options that we will see about the image types. So first one is the raw data type. Okay, raw image type. So raw image type is the universal format. Okay, so universal format that can adopt disk to file. Okay, that means when we select the raw as a image type, it will act as a universal format. That means that particular format is used by all kinds of applications for imaging purpose, that forensics inspectors or forensics team will use any kind of application, that particular type is used in that particular application. Okay, so second one is the smart. Okay, so especially smart is the image type used in the Linux file system. So when we work on Linux platform, so we will have to we have to select smart as a image type. Then next one is the E01, that is the proprietary format for in case. Okay, in case is the another kind of application that is used to create an image like FTK imager. Okay, then last one is the AFF, that is the access data's proprietary format for the access data's application. So in the raw image type, we have to create bit by bit identification, and it is the universal format. So in this particular creating of image, we have to select the raw data, okay, or raw as a type, and that is universally accepted. So after selecting the raw, we have to click on next button. So here that application says that enter the evidence item information. So we have to enter the information like case number. Case number is the 001. Then we have to provide the evidence number, like for example 0001-123. Then unique description. So we have to here enter some data about what is the suspect drive USB. Okay, then examiner name, that is for example Ketan Jogalekar, and notes. Here I am entering the carrying suspect data from device, carrying suspect data from device. So after entering this information, why we require this information? When we collect that particular data in some suspect drive, the forensics team or whatever, the government require that information, that which examiner is have to whatever the data is capturing from that particular suspect drive, and so on. Okay, so for this reason we have to enter that information. So in future, when we require that information, which examiner is examining that particular suspect drive, and so on things, so we have to enter that information, and after entering the information we have to click on next button. So here that particular application says that the image destination folder and image file name. So for that reason we have to select the image destination folder. That means the created image, we have to save that particular image into particular drive or disk. So we have to select that destination drive in some this PC. You have to select at your own, that is you have to save on your drive. I am here creating one folder in the particular G drive. In that particular G drive we have to create one folder, and that is USB suspect, and that USB suspect, select that USB suspect and click on OK button. So in this USB suspect folder you have to save that particular image into that particular image, USB suspect folder. So we have to name the file, for example image one. Okay, so after creating a file name, it will says that image fragment size. That means the file, image file is in divided into crunches, like 1500 MB. By default it is a 1500 MB, but our suspect drive having capacity 8 GB, so we have to create 2400 crunches. Okay, so 2400, that means 2400 MB of size, one fragment having size 2400 MB. So total size is for example 2400 MB means 2 GB multiplied by 4, so that is 4 fragments are created in that particular image file. So image 1, image 2, image 3, and so on, up to 4 fragments are created in that particular USB suspect folder. Okay, so after creating these fragments, we have to click on finish button. Then we have to select, or we have to check that particular verify images after they are created. This is important because that particular information is required after the completion of creating the image. So after the completion of all data, we have to click on start button to create the image. Okay, so we will click on start button. So it will take some time to create an image, and in for that particular image taking some time, but you have to create that particular source drive and destination drive. So you have to confirm that the destination size is more than your source drive, that is your suspect drive, because that particular destination having less size, then the source file or source drive cannot be creating of a source image and saving to destination is not possible when you have not a sufficient storage at the destination. So first you have to confirm that the destination having some space that is available for the source suspect drive to save. So it will take some time for creating an image. It will take 5:53. Okay, so 5:53, and here showing status of that particular creating image is image created successfully. So after creating that image, we have to click on image summary. So in that image summary, we will see all kind of information that is we required already. So created by access data and so on things, the version number of version name and version number of that particular FTK image, then case information acquired using whatever case number is 001, evidence number that we already giving that information as a case information, examiner is the Ketan Jogarekar, and whatever carrying suspect data from the suspect drive or suspect device. Okay, so here is the physical inventory item and all kinds of information. So in that we will require that particular information is important, that is MD5 checksum and SHA-1 checksum. So these are the hash values that we already created from this particular FTK image. Okay, so at backend the hash values are created. Okay, so MD5 and SHA-1 is the checksum algorithms to create the hash values, and this particular hash value is important for our suspect drive. So when we require that particular information, just we have to pass that particular SHA-1 or MD5 hash value, and with this information, the all kind of information in that particular suspect drive is getting from that particular suspect drive. Okay, so that particular information is important for us as a forensics inspector. Okay, so after that getting information, we have to click on OK button, and just we have to click on that particular close button. Okay, so we have to check that particular image file is created or not in our destination drive. So we have to go to the destination drive that we already save that particular data in suspect drives image into G drive. So here G drive we have create one USB suspect. So in the USB suspect there are number of chunks that we already see in the 24 GB, 4 chunks. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, and last one is the 4, image 1004. So image 1001002003004, these are the chunks. Okay, so after creating that image, so here one image 1 is the text document that we already seen the image summary that is already that is also created as a image file, and that is also required for further information. Okay, so that we already see in the image summary. So how to mount that particular image as a drive? So for the, as we see in the first session of that particular tutorial, that is working more and more on less originals, because original drive may be damaged due to electricity failure, due to damaging any kind of information or any kind of activity. Okay, so we have to more work on less originals, And for that, we have to create that particular image in our destination drive, and we will use this as a original drive. Okay, so how to use that particular image as a original drive? Just we have to mount that particular image using FTK imager. So we will see how to do that. Just go to again, here is some information. So we'll go to again FTK imager, then we will go to file menu, and here select one option, that is image mounting. Okay, so after clicking image mounting, it will go to one dialog box, mount image to drive. So we have to select the image that we already created in our G drive. So go to that G drive, USB suspect, and we have to select only that particular first one, image one. Okay, so we have to select that image one and open that. Okay, so mount type physical and logical, keep that. Then drive letter, so next drive letter is available, that is H. Mount block device or read only, we have to keep that by default. Then we have to click on here mount button. So after clicking mount button, see that there is H drive is mapped. So we have to click on close button and see that particular drive is mounted or not. So here is the H drive. F drive is the original drive and H is the image drive that will already mount using the FTK imager. Okay, so we will see that as a original drive. Okay, then we will work that particular drive as a original drive, and original drive is not getting damaged by any kind of activity like electricity failure and so on things. So after mounting, we will analyze that particular data in the suspect drive and so on things. So another type of analyzing the data with the help of the image file is using add evidence item. So for that, we will select, instead of physical drive, we have to select image file, then click on next button, then we have to select that image file that we already created in the USB suspect folder. So in that particular, we have to select only image one and open button, then click on finish. So it will see some data for analyzing the partitions in that particular drive. Okay, so it will see, or it will show the deleted items. Okay, so it will show the deleted items or extra documents and so on things. So there are some data that we already deleted. Okay, so deleted data will automatically recover using the export files. Actually partitioned, we have to select that particular root. So here are showing the n number of things or n number of data that already deleted in the suspect drive. So there are getting the more data to be deleted. So this data can be recovered using this particular FTK imager. So how to recover that? For example, this one is the song that already deleted from this particular suspect drive. So how to recover that? Just right click on the particular deleted file and click on export file, and we have to select the destination drive that we have to recover that particular file to our destination. So we have to select the desktop and click on OK button. So it will be exported or recovered to the desktop. So just we have to check that particular file is exported or not as a recovered file. Just go to desktop and see that particular file is recovered. Whatever nikah bite hue lang ho ki kasak. So here is the recovered file from the suspect drive. So I think we will get the idea of whatever the creating image from the suspect drive, how to analyze the data using that particular FTK image, and how to recover that data using the FTK imager with deleted files also.
Thank you.